Good evening. This is supposed to be a personal reflection on disaster relief planning, but it's a reflection of personal and corporate observations. Chartis Indonesia is an insurance company, belongs to the worldwide operating American International group of companies. I've been here 20 years, solid infrastructure and a lot of pre-planned activity that is available. The truth is, when I was a young kid, I saw in the newsreel, which nobody remembers, I guess, what happened in Holland. The dikes were breaking and people were dying, and that did make an impression that I still remember today. But in Europe, you think about the Red Cross and you think about temporarily what might be necessary to do, but then you forget. Coming to Asia, where catastrophes are the order of the day, you learn a lot faster to respond to these problems. And my arrival in Asia immediately confronted me with a totally new concept of the insurance side. It was 1976 when Typhoon Harlem International Airport, and we're loading these C-130s. I've never slept so good as I did after I came home, because it was really quick breaking work. 20 seconds is a lot of time. not having any experience when it comes to this kind of business, we went to USAID and asked who could we deal with at USAID, were the matchmakers for our ongoing cooperation with CHF International, an American NGO that is extremely good, frugal, and transparent. In Banda Aceh, we had our first project with USAID and CHF International. We spent about $3.5 million. We rebuilt the Banda Aceh fish market. We rebuilt schools, medical facilities, built houses. But the fish market was really the key. I didn't want the fish because it smelled, but it made, at the end of the day, a great difference to the people there. The highlight for me personally was traveling with Petra Nemchova, one of the supermodels, like Naomi Campbell through Banda Aceh, and everybody was jealous of me. But the truth is, she has done a great job with the Happy Hearts Foundation, and we've been working with her to look after the children in Banda Aceh. As soon as the 2007 earthquake struck in Georgia, we decided that we had to step in as well. We visited with the Sultan and, of course, looked at the devastation around Georgia, Bantul, and all the area in central Java. We immediately raised funds, as we did before, from our staff, which was then matched dollar for dollar by the company. We shipped $35,000 worth of supplies, baby food, other foodstuff, water, tents, and what have you, to Georgia, which was then immediately brought to the people in need by CHF International. Together with USAID and CHF International, we went to University Gajah Mada, their faculty for engineering and architecture, and they were extremely cooperative, and we had some contests running for the students who designed shelters. We had 18 projects, selected one for temporary shelter use, which then was the model for a lot of shelters that were being built in central Java. The issue was, we had students from UGM who were working for us day and night, kids on motorcycles going crazy, running through ravines and almost breaking their necks. What happened, we thought, if they have an accident? And for that very reason, we decided that we should provide insurance. After all, that's our business. And we started the concept of providing 24-hour accident insurance for the volunteers who are not used to deal with hammers, bandsaws, and all these dangerous things. This concept is now also being applied to the Bung Hatta University in Padang, and we are also facilitating cooperation between Bung Hatta and UGM so that they can transfer technology. My personal first introduction to these needs was when my friends from Binhaus here in Jakarta took me along to the flooded areas in Kampung Melayu and other areas in Jakarta, and that really spurred an interest in me personally to do something special. Chartis going forward is now cooperating with Maverick, setting up a program which we call FRRE. Here we are trying to educate school children, to educate their parents not to throw garbage wherever they feel like throwing garbage, and to make sure that the drains are not clogged when the next flood is hitting Jakarta. The issue is, insurance will have to play a bigger role in Indonesia until that's the case, until family protection is taken over by the protection through institutions, we will do our part to help the Indonesian people get over the calamities that they're confronted with. Thank you very much.